I believe there isn't really such a thing as being completely self-taught, at least in the way that we think when we're saying that we haven't been taught by someone else. We are always constantly learning, especially online, via platforms like YouTube, online forums and critiques and comments there, and even on social media. And we even get comments from people in real life or our school from our professors. In fact, the only person who can go out there and say that they are completely self-taught is a person that goes out into the world, into nature, grabs their paints and their pencils, and just draws and paints what they see without looking at any other artwork or listening to the feedback of anyone else. I think once anyone with a true artist and creative soul stumbles upon other work that inspires them, they have a drive to create or recreate something similar. And many times we find that we can't really do it, and so we want to figure out, okay, what do I need in order to do that? And we want to do that as quickly as possible, and that is often how many of us begin to look for learning and inspiration from others. I think it can really be dangerous to take a lot of pride in the fact that you might be self-taught, because it can very easily limit you from reaching your true potential. As a matter of fact, this started to happen to me recently as I noticed a limitation in my growth as an artist. I realized that I didn't want to end up like Frieza from Dragon Ball. Now you're probably shocked, and even if you're familiar with Dragon Ball, let me explain what I mean quickly. Dragon Ball is an anime that features two main characters, Goku and Vegeta. They are the heroes of the story oftentimes, and through many arcs, they are faced with a villain named Frieza. Frieza is quite powerful and he's a threat to almost everyone that's around him. However, he was never really too much of a match for Goku and Vegeta and always ended up being defeated by them at the end of very many long standoff episodes, as you may know if you've watched any season of Dragon Ball. The thing about Frieza though is that he never trained for a day in his life up until the very last moment. And if you know anything about Goku and Vegeta, they are Saiyans. Their race is a warrior race, and they have been training their entire lives. But Frieza, he never trained, and he was still quite a match for them many times in the story arcs. It wasn't until Dragon Ball Super, which is the most recent and up-to-date season from the canon story of Dragon Ball, that Frieza decided to train. And once he did, he became extremely powerful, and he gained a lot of new skills, even a new final form. Unfortunately, he was still not really a match for Goku and Vegeta because their training had continued to allow them to ascend and reach insane godly levels of power. So let's bring this back to art, right? What I say I don't want to be like Frieza, what I'm saying is that I don't want to get to the point where I'm too complacent and arrogant of my skills and I feel like I don't need anyone or anything else in order to improve. Even though I've won awards through middle school and high school for my artwork, and I've had accolades from my friends and peers at school my entire life, and I've even made a name for myself here online as Ergo Josh in social media, I still don't want to lose sight of what my greatest potential could be as an artist. Frieza was an example of your extremely talented and perfectly gifted individual from birth, but Vegeta and Goku, through their sheer will and determination, realized that through training, they could reach their ultimate and ultimately discover Ultra Instinct. So if you're still watching, I want to tell you exactly what I mean when I say that I want to reach my full potential. I know that artists can come off as very pretentious a lot of the time, and especially as I've made a lot of videos here on YouTube, I've read your comments and I've noticed that some of you who see me as art goals, or some of you who see me as someone to inspire you for your art or your journey, you feel really down when you hear me talk badly about my own art. But I want to really clarify what I mean here so that you can understand where I'm coming from. And I do apologize. In the past, I have been quite abrasive towards myself and in a way that I don't think is very necessary or helpful for anyone to do. I never really doodled in school, I just scribbled. The only thing that I would do in class when I wasn't doing my work is I would actually be working on my big final drawings that I would have for art class. Having a personal sketchbook and filling it, something that's super common to understand and see here on YouTube, is something that was completely foreign to me. The way I started was actually in preschool, and I would be tracing things from coloring books that I had. and I would give those tracings to people and they would really enjoy it. And then eventually I moved on to crafts like origami. Eventually I joined everyone else in drawing anime girls because I discovered manga, and I got some manga books from Christopher Hart. Those books aren't really too great, but I loved them as a kid. And yeah, I didn't get very far with those whatsoever. I think partially was because I didn't really understand what anime was. I just knew manga was a thing that you could get if you lived in Japan, and yeah, I wasn't really familiar with how these shows and animations really worked. I started to draw people around age 12 once I got a How to Draw People book. It was pretty good. I was really excited. I would draw eyes and noses right before school, and that made me super happy. But I quickly realized that there was such a thing as the grid method, and that allowed me to get a much higher level of skill for my artwork much faster, and so I just dropped drawing freehand right then and there. So what I did was I got good at rendering, I got good at shading, and I continued doing that until I was about 22 years old. I never drew freehand regularly until I was about 22, and that's, if you're counting, about 10 years of not practicing the skill that I have come to cherish the most, which is drawing using reference and then partially from your imagination to create something, a collaboration of things that doesn't exist yet to tell a story. What I would do is I would always focus on the concept of my work, and I would always focus on the final image, and I would find whatever technique and use whatever media I needed that would allow me to get to that point, except for the computer, because I wasn't really interested in digital manipulation at the time, especially because my computer was absolutely terrible. And even when I started to go to college in 2013 at age 18, I discovered digital art, but then I just went back to tracing and even tried to post some of my stuff as if it wasn't traced, which was terrible. And it's why I removed all of that stuff from the internet. So don't trace, guys. You're going to regret it later on, at least if you're trying to pass it off as if you didn't trace. So I'm sure you can kind of understand now that even though I can create pretty decent quality images that can get a lot of attention from people on Instagram too, I'm not satisfied because my imagination is here, but my ability to run with it and iterate and design and develop stories by drawing is just so low, and I want to match that. When that skill disparity begins to stretch too far apart, it's very easy to get frustrated and depressed with your work. One thing I wanted to add about being self-taught, I don't want you to think that your value is less, that I'm trying to equalize everyone. I'm really trying to do the opposite of that, because it's about your work ethic and how hard you work. Any college art class, to be completely honest, I can name you a few artists that I've been looking at, and they all say the same thing, and they're professionals working in the industry already. What happens when you take a course is that some of the people will kind of give up at a certain point. Some of the people will slack off and only do half of the work or the bare minimum. Some of the people will only do what's expected, and sometimes that's enough. But there'll be a few people who will go above and beyond. There are going to be people who live and breathe artwork. You know, there's going to be people who do everything that they can to make sure that they get the most out of their instructor, the most out of their time, and the most out of their brain power in order to learn how to do everything that they want to do. And so those people are usually the ones that stand out. You know, the school is wanting them to come back and represent them because they want to use them to inspire others to come back to their school. I just want to remind you guys and let you know that, yes, we're all self-taught in a way, but it's really about how much you teach yourself. Everyone can go and get a critique from their favorite artist at a convention, but one or two people will actually leave that and change their life and do the work that's necessary or do what they were told in order to make it somewhere new. And there's going to be people who run around the whole convention floor and ask questions all day, and they never really get anywhere because they don't do anything or remember anything important. But just wanted to let you guys know that. Make sure you don't feel discouraged by this. Make sure that you feel encouraged to do the most and to make the most of whatever you have available to you, whether that's YouTube tutorials or whether that's you being in an art class already and you have an instructor who's doing amazing work. Take advantage of that. Make sure you're the person that they remember that, wow, this person's serious. This person is gonna actually go somewhere and do something. And I might even put in a little bit more effort to help them out. If you're interested though at taking a stab at learning from other people after watching this video, I recommend Skillshare. They didn't sponsor this video, but I do have a link that will get you 2 months free Skillshare membership. And you can click on that. And one instructor that I recommend is Gabrielle Bricky. She's actually, not only have I learned so much from her, and if you look at her art style and her tutorials and stuff, you'll see it's the similarities. And but she's also having a course coming up soon, and I recommend that you get it to be ready for when that comes out. And so yeah, thank you guys for watching. This was a very chill video, but I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you in the next one. Peace.